Welcome back, Hot Wheel Collectors. Have I ever got a video for you guys. Today we've got the Hot Wheel Flea Market Haul. I was at a massive flea market not too long ago, an automotive flea market here in Canada. And when I go to these things, I just pick and get everything that's cool, that's die-cast, preferably 1/64 scale. And this time around, I've got a whole bunch of super rare stuff to show you. Some really cool finds, everything from Lesney to Matchbox, Hot Wheels, Majorette, and even some really rare stuff. Some of those standing Transformer figures. I don't even remember what that is, but we'll look at the bottom of that truck. It is something really old and rare, very cool. Fits right into the 1/64 scale die cast. But check out some of these Majorette Monster Movers and Series 3000. This is something that we do find in Canada quite frequently when you're looking hard for it. We've got the old cab over truck with the horses and the trailer. We've got two of those actually. These two haven't even been out of the plastic yet. The cardboard is missing, the Honda F1, but we're going to get all this stuff out. These are all Majorette. We've got an articulated truck right there, a B-train if you will. Some made in France cars that you don't normally see. Pick those things up as well. And some rare variations. So let's just get right into it. Sit back and enjoy. It's hard to know where to begin with a collection like this, or a pick like this, I should say. So let's just start from left to right, because it's just, I've got everything set out here kind of by brand, and it's just too much cool stuff from all the brands to just start picking away individually. So let's go from left to right. Look at this thing. We've got a B-train from Majorette. This thing is just super cool. You don't see this stuff all that often anymore. It's simply called a Ford scale 1/100th, all metal. Pretty cool things, and they do come apart, of course. It's got a hitch in between, so you can separate the two. This in itself is a vehicle with many different tempo variations that you can find from Majorette, although not all that easily depending on which country you're looking in, especially the United States. Majorette is not the easiest thing to find there. This is more of a European brand, so if you're in Europe, maybe not all parts of Europe, but most likely this stuff is a little easier to find, and in Canada it did make quite the appearance back in the late 1980s and through the 1990s. We've also got the Ford Forgeon, I think it's called, or Foreign. This one's just called the U.S. Van. They have changed the name on this one a few times. It is 1/65th scale. Always featuring opening doors on the back. Quite a detailed interior, all metal. This one has the large rectangular windows as well as the custom opera windows on the back. We've got two rectangles and a circle. Flame tampos. It's not mint, but what a cool vehicle. And as you can see, the scale is just right with most Hot Wheels. Here we have the BMW Z or M3, I do believe, M3 or Z3. Hopefully I'm not getting that too wrong, but anyways, it is a BMW Roadster. We'll call it a Roadster. Let's get back to the Majorette though. The Ford Depenuse. I'm probably saying that wrong because I'm not French. There it is. Hopefully you can pronounce it a little better than I do if I am getting that wrong. Or was this a Chevy? It's a Chevy. Sorry, it is a Chevy. To me, it's just a big old Chevy Silverado. This one's got the Mustang tampos on it. Wild Mustang, it's called. Quite a nice big heavy truck. It's got full suspension. All metal. And this one here is in mint condition. I've been kind of looking for one of these for a while and stumbled across this one. It is a bank truck, security bank truck, armored vehicle, let's call it. I don't think there's, bank security, it says on the bottom. 1/57th scale by Majorette, made in France. Quite often these back sliding doors, or it's not even a sliding door, it's a roll up door. These are quite frequently broken. On this truck, it works perfectly. What a cool vehicle. And funny little story for this one. I had two of these as a kid. One of them was pretty beat up that I think I traded with a neighbor friend. And I remember very vividly at this time taking a sledgehammer to it, and it took quite a pounding before it turned into many shards of diecast. I still have the original one that I had as a child, and now I have this mint one, so quite a nice addition to my collection. Furthering to the majorettes, we do have a lot of majorette to show you today, and that I am very happy for, as I will be doing a majorette specific video in the near future. Here we have a Jeep Grand Cherokee, or Wagoneer, I do believe. I don't even think it has a name on it. It definitely, no, it's been blanked out, you can see, but this is like a Grand Wagoneer two-door, opening tailgate, bunch of crud in the back, don't really know what it is, probably could find out if I looked a little closer. This one's got the Safari tampos on it with all the little four-fingered prints all over the roof and the hood and the sides. Nice truck, full suspension. I have several variations of this one already, and some of them are monster trucks, which is super cool. Continuing to the majorettes, look at this, a little VW Golf. Max Motor, I guess it's supposed to be. Star Rally, opening tailgate, if you will. Seems to be a little jammed. Ooh, it's just stiff. There we go. You've got the opening tailgate, real trailer hitch on the back, full suspension. This one's a bit of a strange scale compared to most of the cars. It is 155 scale on the bottom, as you can see. Or 156, as it may be. So it doesn't quite fit in perfectly with some Hot Wheels, because for a little VW, it's a little bit too big. But it is a cool model, and for that I'm thankful. Here is a non-favorite of mine, the oversized Ferrari. I think this is the 3-something GTO. No, they just call it the GTO. It's a cool model, but the scale is just a little too large, again, just like the VW for most of my collection. 156. This is a fairly common vehicle from majorette. It's got the opening hood. I do believe this one was released for a good long time, or in large quantities at least, because I do have quite the collection of these in various conditions. So really nothing to report home about on that one. It's got the suspension, of course. That is pretty much it for the Hot Wheel, or the majorette 164 scale-ish smaller vehicles. Let's get into something interesting. These trucks, for instance. These trucks are really quite something. These are the majorette 3000 series, also known as super movers or construction vehicles. This one in particular came with three plastic horses. You've got two grazing horses and one striding horse, I would say. They all stand on their own. But the truck is the coolest part. It's got two fold-down plastic doors. We'll clip those in place right after we see. You can see the door on the back. And it's got like a camper front in the top here. This is removable from the truck. You can see you can lounge about in the front. There's like a dinette table. And an opening sunroof of sorts. It's kind of like a pop top. This part is plastic. The white here, the bottom green part is all metal. This is a 1/60th scale, as you can see on the bottom. Majorette, there is the back door. There is the side door. It's got grazing Mustangs, as we would call them, on the sides. And these doors do clip up, just as you can see. Oh, hold on a second. There you go, little click. Same for the back one. And now you've got it. So here's the cab. The cab is, in my opinion, the best part. It's got a metal horn. This one's a little crooked. Looks like Pa's slipper may have slipped onto it. It's got a sticker on the top. There are no tampos on these vehicles. These are old enough that they are stickers. Clip-in rear hitch portion to allow the camper to stick to it. 1/60th scale, made in France, majorette. Articulated wheels, all full suspension, all metal. And of course, you've got the hitch part on the back here. This one seems to be, oh my gosh. There we go. Just took a little bit of work to get her in. And there you have it. The truck is fully connected. Really nice 1/60th scale. Putting that next to a traditional Hot Wheel, as you can see, we'll take a couple, one from 1968 and one from about 2000 and something. Put it next to each other, you can see this is a nice scale for most vehicles, a very accurate scale. Not like some of the other 1/100 scale vehicles that you see from all lines, Hot Wheels, Matchbox, and Majorette. This is a rare out-of-production scale for these vehicles, and truly my favorite. So, the horses would have gone into the back of the trailer. You would store the plastic horses back there. And there you have it. On to the next Majorette truck, and we, without having to go through all the details twice, here's one that's never been out of its plastic package. This would have had a full cardboard surround around it, similar to the Majorette construction tractor. You can see it has a plastic shell inside. We'll get to more to that one after we look at the trucks. This one has not been out of its package. There are some cracks in it, but really, it's time for this beast to come out. There's really no reason for it to be stuck in here. Let's get this beast out. Excuse me and all the commotion, but I'm really not one for keeping things into sterile, yellowing, deteriorating plastic when you've got such a beautiful truck. This one is completely mint. This is the first time this truck has ever experienced fresh oxygen on its paint. It is going to have all three horses in the back, as I would suspect. There they are. They've never even, they're not even off their spurs yet. I'm not sure. I can almost, I'll just share it with you. I can smell a scent of, well, I would call fresh plastic, but I believe it is stale. The horses are a little strange looking because they are not off their spur. Maybe there's more than three. We'll find out very shortly. Opening up the other side of the trailer. This has never been opened before. And keep in mind that these trucks are from the late 1980s to early 1990s, most likely. It would appear that the first truck we looked at was missing a horse, because we have got four horses here. On the spur, we've got, well, looks like we've got two grazing horses and two walking horses. They're rather slippery in texture, as they've never been handled, and the plastic is probably I don't know what the word is, but anyways, it's got a bit of a slippery texture, if I would like to describe that with you. The truck is clearly in immaculate condition, as are the stickers. We've got the rodeo stickers on it. You can see that as a sticker. It's even starting to curl right there, just ever so slightly. Rodeo Texas, it's called. What a handsome, handsome truck. Same thing, it's got the opening skylight on the back. More stickers on the front, and they are starting to lift again. As you can see, there, oh, may have to get some glue under that. These are not tampos, as they are often found on Hot Wheels. But just a wonderful, wonderful casting. Super heavy. If I were to put a guess on the weight of this, I would say nearly 2 pounds. Oh, there, first time separated from its hitch. And let's see if it connects a little bit more solidly. It's probably going to go together with a click, unlike the first one. Yes, it does. All right, so there's those two trucks, and just side by side, there they are. Same exact vehicle, just different paint jobs, different tampos, and short one horse on the green and white version. Let's get right into the last. Oh, see, that one's loose. See, it's a little bit worn out on the hitch there. as per the age of the vehicle. We'll get the old upside down horses out of the picture. The last one here, this has not been opened. Yes, I only paid $15 Canadian. That equates to about $11 or $12 US at a flea market. So these really didn't cost me anything when you count into the fact that most of the time you're paying shipping on these things. And to find them mint in the packaging, or most of the packaging, is just quite incredible. How are we going to open this one up? This packaging isn't nearly as brittle. Find a seam. Find a seam and get it out of the package. Oh my goodness, this is quite the struggle sometimes. Just like in the, just like nowadays, packaging was key. And here you have it. This is the Honda F1 World Champion 1988 race configuration of this truck. This one has a completely different configuration. The box is mostly plastic. It is metal up until here. The rest is plastic with stickers. Spare tires on the top. This one has a ramp that comes down to allow the F1 racer come out of the box or out of the container. You can see it's tucked in there quite nicely. And as I know, I do have several of these in different paint variations. You have to tilt up here, tilt plastic, and this car actually locks into place on its front wheels into a clip inside the vehicle. There we go. And then ideally, you can pull it out through the side, but you most likely, keep it realistic, you would roll this car back out the back ramp. And there you have it. This is the car that we're looking at. It is a, let's see if we can focus, please, a Sienna Honda. Made in France, 155 scale. F1 McLaren number 289. This is a regular production collector car from Majorette. However, I'm not sure that you could find it with this specific tampo without having it from this truck set. The truck set itself has a lot of unique details. You can look in here. There are tools literally printed on the plastic in the back, if you can see through the red plastic. Quite a lot of detail. Very nicely done. A lot of, this is a full sticker right across the side. If you're buying these in less than mint condition or that have been exposed to play or sunlight, you're going to find that these stickers are not in this condition. This is a very rare condition for this vehicle unless you're buying it literally brand new out of the package. And if you're shopping on eBay, expect to pay a humongous amount of money for these things. Because, like I said, they're only being sold mainly out of European countries with massive shipping amounts. And it's one of the joys of living in Canada to be able to find these things fairly readily at vintage flea markets. Not to say they're easy to find, and hence why I never dicker when I'm buying these things. I really just, what do you want for it? Sold. One of my favorites, really. We've got one last Majorette now to show you, and it also has never been out of the package. This one is part of the Majorette construction fleet. As you can see, these things are likely from France or Quebec. Serie 4500, not even English. And again, French wording above action moving parts. This thing is primarily meant for the French market. This one is unpunched, as you can see by the sticker, or by the, anyways, you know what I'm talking about. This one here is the Serie 4500, and it is a enterprise tractor of some kind. A lot of moving parts on these ones, as you can see. Here we have the details. It has a moving, rear grader piece of some sort. The front shovel moves up and the cab is removable. Other vehicles in the lineup include a roller, front shovel, the cement mixer, which I do have, some sort of scoop, and a flatbed with a 1/100 scale tractor on the back. I have one of those as well. Those are fairly common, as are the cement mixers. The other ones, a little harder to find. And it's got some really cool graphics on the top, too. This is the actual toy. It's not an actual vehicle, as you would imagine. Most modern playsets feature like a picture of a real vehicle. But this one, $15. $15, and when was this thing produced? Let's just kind of get an idea of how long it has been in the package. If we could find a copyright on here, that would be great, but it's all in foreign language. I'm not seeing a copyright at all. I do know it is very old, because when I was a child, these things were new, and that was 20-odd years ago. As you can see, it's got a wonderful articulated bucket here, and it even has a lever so that you can actually move the bucket just with the lever. Rubber tracks. These are movable rubber tracks. Very flexible still. No signs of age or decay. This one features real tampos, not stickers on it. And then you've got that road scraper of sorts. I'm not sure what they actually call that because I don't work in construction. But that's for kind of grooving the road prior to paving, I do believe. Works quite well. How is the scale? Let's put it next to a majorette vehicle. We'll use that 1/60th scale Jeep. Pretty much could fill the bucket with almost the Jeep. Or, well, entirely the Jeep. And the removable roof piece, I'm not sure why you would need to remove that, but it is removable. I imagine if you're looking for these in the used market, quite often that is going to be gone or missing if it's not in perfect condition, because that came off way too easily. This thing is fresh as the day it was built, in my opinion. The rubber is really flexible. The plastic is great. Lots of shine. An absolutely wonderful piece. I will keep the cardboard on that one. I kind of destroyed the plastic, but it's really the vehicle I'm after. So let's get on to the next vehicles. We showed the majorette. Now getting into the Hot Wheels. Let's have a look at some of those, because everyone collects Hot Wheels if you're into diecast, I would think. Got a whole range of cars, right from 1968. We've got the Thunderbird, or T-Bird, I believe. The TNT-Bird, as it's called. We're just going to have a quick look at the base here. This one has the full spring suspension. As you can see here, the springs. These are the original Redline wheels. This one is in fairly rough condition. And I did only pay, I think, $2 or $3 for this car. As a restorable piece, it's great because it has an uncracked windshield. It has all of the parts. And the wheels and axles are fairly straight, other than missing their chrome. So if you're into the restoration type market, a car like this is the prime example for a restoration. Doesn't take much to polish those windows back up to a regular new car shine. And with all the parts and no actual physical damage to the diecast, these cars are quite valuable. For me, I just enjoy the old vehicles. I'm really not a collector of the 1968 to 73 cars due to the extreme rarity and value of them. I do pick them up when I can. I do enjoy the sentimental value of them. The next oldest car I did pick up from the Hot Wheels was this 1975 Olds 442. Fire Chief, it is called. This one has the red line wheels, and you can see what I mean about the new versus old red line wheels. This one has a more conical pointed hubcap, whereas the more modern 1975 and up red line wheel is a flat, more modern style red line that you'll still see on black walls today, minus the red line tire. This car is in fairly rough shape, but you can't let these just sit there forlornly on a table at a couple bucks. You gotta pick them up when you see them. Next up, and in no particular order, is this 1978 released 57 Chevy. Fairly common car, but in any condition, they're fairly fun to find at a dollar or so. I think I paid 50 cents or a dollar for this one. Definitely not a mint example, but a great displayable piece, and also just a fun piece to have. I do have a mint one already, so just a nice piece to pick up and save from the thrashing of some child that has two quarters in his pocket. And also here we've got the 1983 released Cobra AC, or Shelby AC Cobra. This one has an opening hood. The engine is still shiny, and most of all, these cars are hard to find with the windshield and rear roll bar intact for the front driver's seat, as they are often flattened or completely ripped off from play wear and use. This one is in great shape, and the paint job is not too bad either, so also a steal at the $1 Canadian that I paid for it. Released in 1987, we've got the 34 Ford. This one has a casting date of 1979 on it, as it was released prior in different paint jobs. But this is probably one of the rarest and hardest to find paint jobs in the common mainline series. A great find at $5, in my opinion. Not a chip on it. This is not the high raker. These cars didn't come with a high raker until slightly later, which is an axle that lifted down, and features all small wheel black walls, which is kind of a unique feature on this particular casting. Next up, we've got the Mercedes 380 SEL. I believe this thing was released in the mid to late 1980s, although I can't remember off the top of my head. It does feature the German Shepherd in the back seat, staring out the window. This one's in great shape, features the gold Hot One wheels, which does have some suspension to it. Some of the smoothest and quietest rolling Hot Wheels you ever find are these original gold Hot One wheel featured cars. It wasn't just on the Mercedes 380 SAL, you could find this on several cars, versus how a new car rolls, which rolls just as well. This one has a noticeably smoother sound to it, all in thanks to the gold Hot One wheel and suspension that was period correct for the time when this car was released. And really one of my favorites, because Hot Wheels did not make too many four-door cars. Not to say it didn't make any, however, as here are a couple international models that I found. Very hard to find, let alone in a flea market. We've got the Peugeot 505, made in France. This one is a beigey brown color, very flat coloration on it. Black wall wheels. Typically quite rare, actually, especially in the US market. I did pay around $15, I believe, for this one, $15 or $20. But to see this one with no chips on it and only slight dullification of the paint, I really couldn't just let it sit there unloved. I had to save it. The next international car that I found was this France-released Taxi Service Malibu. I do believe this is a Malibu. It does not say it on the bottom. It just calls it purely the Taxi, made in France, 1982. This would have been released around 1986 in this paint series and from this country. Otherwise, it would have had a black tint window with black print on the side instead of red. It does strangely say USA Taxi Service. It almost looks like USR, which would be a Russian car, but this is in fact a USA paint job with the fake phone number on it, starting with 555 behind the front fender. Pretty rare car. Picked this one up for $10. Really no paint chips on it. Slight wear to the tampo. Very hard car to find. And the one that I have currently is completely crushed on the roof. And the tampos are long gone. Chips all over it. So I really couldn't let this one sit there either. It also has the gold Hot One wheels with the smooth sounding axles. Slight suspension. And just an overall very rare car. Nice one to pick up for my collection. Moving on, we've got this 1987 released Monster Vet from Hot Wheels. This one has the yellow paint, blue tint windows. Most often you're going to find these things with a black tint window. CT or the OCT, the off-road construction tire is what OCT stands for. These are just construction tire. The OCT has a different wheel hub than these ones, same style or size wheel. But very hard to find this with the blue tint window. It's a very rare combination, and I'm not sure really why. I do think it has something to do with being an international release. And being in Canada, this would qualify for as a international release versus the typical United States release, which had the black tint windows. And here we have a mid-2000s release, I do believe. What do we call this before? A BMW M Roadster. Just M Roadster is what they're calling it. I gave it a designation of some number. Maybe I'm incorrect, but this is the M. I believe it is an M3 Roadster. One of my favorite Hot Wheels. Proportionally very correct in scale and size and dimensions. This one has the SP5 wheels on it. There were a couple variations. This is the most common of those. But just a really nice all-metal heavy casting, considering it's a convertible. No chips and, well, it's got a few scuffs on that fender, actually. But the one I have in my collection is pretty messed up, so that was an improvement at 50 cents. Here's a Hot Wheel I had not seen before, a Volkswagen Beetle. Still have not done any research on this one, so I can't tell you anything else about it other than it says Robo Zoo on the side. Black metal base, SP5 wheels, clear windows. Pretty sure that probably came out of a 5-pack or some sort of special. It certainly isn't a mainline car, or I would probably recognize that, as I do have a whole inventory, thousands of Hot Wheels stuck in my brain, just not that one. Let's move on to something else now, Majorette and Lesney. Well, I did miss a few Hot Wheels, so before we get into Lesney, just a quick little recap. Here is a Hot Wheels Funny Bird, Firebird Funny Car of some sort. Completely thrashed, so really not much to write home about that one. The Dodge Caravan, also thrashed. These are like 1/4 cars, 25-cent cars. Ice cream van. Just to be a real completist here and show you everything I actually did buy. We had these ones as well. The Hot Wheel Classics, SS Express, mangled, mouse-chewed card on this one. Beautiful Hot Wheel, though. All metal. 2008 release from the Hot Wheel Classics series. I believe this is Series 5. Yes, it is. All metal with the red line 5 spokes on it. Wonderful casting. The other two I did not want to open yet until I confirm that I do not have them or do have them in my current carded collection. 52 Chevy truck in metallic orange. And the 56 Chevy in chrome. Thinking I might have that one actually. Last two Hot Wheels before we get into the Matchbox were two mainline cars. Both the cards are kind of mangled. Not really that bad, but considering these were only released in 2006, we might as well open them up. We've got the Plymouth Superbird. I remember vividly buying lots of these back in the day. Really nice casting, plastic base, 5 spokes. Super nice car. And of course, a 1969 Dodge Charger. This one had the opening hood before Mattel elected to make it cast shut. This one had a opening hood, plastic base, There you have it, with a metal engine under the hood. Very nicely detailed, silver trim fenders. The old Super B stripe on the back of sorts. Really nice car. Okay, now we'll get into the Matchbox. We've got some really cool Matchbox to show you. Everything from cars to trucks to ambulance to big old 18-wheelers. One package vehicle to open up. And a really old Lesney, as well as my favorite, the big old Lincoln Continental. I buy these things everywhere I can. One of my favorite cars. Lincoln Continental Mark V, all metal. Beautiful proportions on this car. Heavy duty. Just a wonderful, one of the best castings ever made by Matchbox, in my opinion, in the super fast years. And is it ever super fast? Let's go back in time, though, and start out with this fire truck. And I've already got the ladder extended. This is a rare find to find this vehicle, let alone with the metal. This is a metal ladder that rotates 360 degrees in the back with a hydraulic pin that allows it to raise and lower and maintain its position. This one amazingly features the extending plastic ladder portion in mint condition. I do not have any of these things that feature the original ladder. However, the only thing missing is one of the gold, or it's actually like a metal, it's a brass little siren that was stuck on the other side. Should have been two of them. And it is missing three of the tires. However, these are fairly easy to find, even original as parts on other more derelict vehicles. This one, I would say, is a survivor. It has the original Tampo stickers on it. I think they're stickers, not Tampos. Kent Fire Brigade. The door sticker, number 15. Painted quite nicely with the grille and the headlights. Stickers all the way around. No real damage to it. This is a number 13 from the Matchbox Series King Size, made in England. Just back off a little bit on the camera there. And like I said, a fully rotating ladder piece. Something really cool. Approximately 160 to 164 scale by the looks of it. Just to put another car in front in perspective. So, a little different from the 1/100s. I think these are actually 1/87 scale. We'll just bring both of these over. Matchbox made a lot of trucks in this scale, including single cabs without the trailers. These things featured opening rear doors on the plastic boxes. As you can see, we've got a fully opening box for the Valvoline trailer. Metal base. And a very nicely detailed metal cab, plastic base with a plastic grille. Appears to be either a Peterbilt or a Kenworth. See if it says on the bottom. It does. It is a Kenworth Aerodyne. It's a Kenworth Aerodyne. So there you go. These ones don't have the click-in thing. You just merely drop the hitch in place and off you go. Nicely articulated vehicle. The scale's all messed up, though, when you park one of these cars next to it. If you're a scale crazy person, it doesn't really make much sense to have a vehicle same size as the cab of a Kenworth. However, they are extremely cool. Here we've got a cab over. This is also, what is this? This is also a Kenworth, says right there on the base. Plastic bottom. Nice exhaust stacks. Very nicely detailed for a 1/87 scale vehicle. I believe it's 1/87. This one might say 1/90 scale to be precise. Mannheim Auctions by Phil Parsons. This is like a flap down type trailer instead of the barn door. Very cool. Nice collection. Guess how much I paid for these? 3, 2, 1. I paid $1 each. A very rare find at that price in this condition. Also $1 was this 1970s release ambulance. Opening doors on it as well. Detailed interior of some sort. All metal. And in absolutely mint condition. This is not an uncommon vehicle, but in this condition, it is getting up there in the uncommon condition. Like for this type of vehicle, it's the only thing on it is some dust, really. It's very nice. We've got a newer version here of the Land Rover. This isn't that old, but it does have a metal base. The Land Rover 90. Everyone loves that. It's got the full suspension. Plastic red guard on the front. Plastic roof. Full suspension, as I said. Rolls really quite nice. And not overly desirable, but here we have one of these kind of custom Matchbox, Team Matchbox, what they call all metal. It's called a High Tailor. It's got the wheels with the thin stripes on it to give it faster rollability. Rolls very smoothly, almost like a Hot Wheels, gold Hot One type wheel. It has a sticker on it instead of a tampo, so this is quite an old vehicle, just because based on the stickers. Unfortunately, it is missing one side of the engine bay's tailpipes, completely broken off. This is not an overly valuable car to begin with, but it is kind of cool. And it would be fun to see what it does on the raceway, on a Hot Wheels raceway, just to see what it does anyways. That's it for the Matchbox. We've only got a few cars left, some really crazy ones. We've got a Johnny Lightning, we've got a Tomica. Oh, we've got this Matchbox, but hold on a second. We've got this Transformer type car. Wait till you see what that turns into. And these old things. Like, what the heck are these? We'll have a look at that. And what's this thing? We've got a real toy Isuzu Viacross. I just liked it. It was so realistic looking. It's got like clear plastic or clear painted wind or headlights, turn signals. Really nice, you know, really good detail. License plate. These aren't overly collectible, they're not even that old, but heck, why the heck not buy that for a couple cents, you know? Last but not least, we've got this Matchbox roadside vehicle. It's got some good tampos on it. It's from the year 2000. Can't imagine these are worth all that much. I'm pretty sure I have one loose somewhere, so we're not going to open that one up just to be sure. Probably have it elsewhere, but let's look at these things. What is this thing? What is this? It's a Transformer. Yes, it is. Let's see if we can take a peek at his head. He's got like a head there built into his windscreen. He's got little fists on him. Some feet with some wheels attached. Let's zoom back out here. MERS! MERS! Anyways, what does he do? Well, these things move back up into the car's pelvic region. Let's call it. It is a bit tight, I notice. It's a bit tight. Might be the order in which I'm doing things, but it just might also be. There we go. And there. Look what it turned into. It's called a Rothman's Porsche. Number one. You would never know that this thing was a Transformer unless you turn it over. And made in 1983 in Japan. It's got real rubber tires, all metal, and stickers, no tampos. Quite cool. I am going to be looking at more of these and hopefully acquiring a few more of them as well, as they are, you know, very much the same scale as Hot Wheels and Matchbox. Pretty cool vehicle, actually. Going way, 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 way back. We've got three or four vehicles left here. Look at this thing. What the heck is that? A Fordson made by Dinky. We've got one of my first Dinky toys. I have not collected much in the way of Dinkies. These are made in England. It's approximately 1/64 scale. It's got hard rubber tires on it. A trailer hitch of some kind. The license plate has been painted red by someone. It shouldn't have been painted red. It should have just been black with the bumper and the base. Most of the paint is missing on this vehicle. It was originally green. It still is green, but very, very heavy. Probably weighs about a pound all by itself. It's just heavy duty. Perfectly 1/64 scale, unlike many Dinkies. And on the back, we've got this Ertl made What the heck's that movie called? Oh man, brain fart here. Anyways, one of you guys will let me know in the comments. This is one of those old shoot 'em up movies there with I'm so sad that I can't remember this right now. Anyways, pretty cool car. Made by Ertl. Doesn't say much on the way of the base for description. Disney licensed. Doesn't say much. Rubber tires. I've actually got about 20 of these things. I just buy them whenever I can. I got a whole bunch for Dick Tracey. My goodness. It says right on the trunk. How come I couldn't remember that? Dick Tracey. If you're a youngster, you probably don't even know what that is. But it's a cool car and a cool old show and movie and whatever. Johnny Lightning next. Let's move past that embarrassment. We've got the old Dodge A100 truck here with the flap down box here. Lots of detail. Check out those rear seats in the back. How much fun would that be? We've got three bucket seats facing backwards. And I believe this is an A100 Dodge. 1965 Dodge pickup. Made by Playing Mantis back in the day before several company changeovers. This is a really cool vehicle. The main reason why I picked this thing up was, it's at a flea market. Obviously, I'm going to buy it, but it is the Project in Progress series Dodge A100. One of the few Project in Progress vehicles I did not have. I think this probably very nearly completes my entire Project in Progress Johnny Lightning collection. If you're not familiar with Project in Progress, do look at some of my other videos or check them out on eBay and just see what those are all about. They're ultra cool. Last but not least, the Tomica Isuzu Bonnet Bus. Here you go, all metal, very heavy. Really, really nice details on this thing. Ultimately, the scale is horribly off with most of my collection, as it is probably around 1/150th or so. It may 1/110th. It says right there on the bottom. Number 6 in the Tomica collection. Let's just take a close look at a few examples of why the scale is so off for my collection, but it is still cool. Here we have a 1/90th scale truck. And next to it, let's get a approximately a 1/65th scale Lincoln. And to make matters worse, which I don't really want to do because that's not really what I'm after here, got the 1/55th scale Volkswagen. So you can see why a collection with such differences in scale, although they're all the same size, matchbox size, it is rather absurd and hard to display them together because it just looks so mismatched in my opinion. Mind you, I do have a little of the old OCD going on. Let me know what you think of the haul. And lots more videos coming up. Trying to get a few more out there. I got lots to show you guys and girls. Happy hunting and stay tuned for the future Hot Wheel Lair video coming up.